Pay attention to what you're doing. I mean, it's kids. It's not adults, it's kids. Don't pass a school bus.
Tonight, the community of Greenwood continues to plead for the person responsible in a hit and run to come forward. Police don't yet have a break in this case. It's been almost a week since police say the person driving a mid-sized four-door dark-colored sedan struck a 14-year-old Greenwood High School student, ignoring a bus's stop arm and flashing lights.
The student is okay, but as WRTV's Caitlin Kendall reports, the community continues to plead for the suspect to turn themselves in.
Nearly a week later.
It's just people don't know. They don't care. Everybody's worried about themselves.
And folks who work on Main Street in Greenwood.
It breaks my heart.
Say they just don't understand how someone could hit a kid boarding their bus and drive off.
Just turn yourself in and then slow down and make sure you're looking both ways before you're going anywhere near those bus stops at.
Megan Brevard works at a barber shop just down the street from where the crash happened. And says as a mother, she can't help but feel heartbroken for the family of the 14-year-old who was hit.
Just turn yourselves in. I can't imagine what the parents are going through right now. I have a 13-year-old little boy. I would be devastated. Just turn yourselves in.
Robert Webb, who owns a tattoo shop on Main Street, says he sees people recklessly driving down this street daily and adds many people simply just don't pay attention.
People drive up and down this road like crazy people all the time.
The bus driver told police their stop arm was extended with its lights flashing when the boy and another student crossed the traffic to board the bus. That's when the bus driver says the first child cleared the lane before the 14-year-old was hit. Police added the driver was traveling at a high rate of speed. The bus driver noted that they even honked their horn to let the driver know, but it was too late.
Greenwood police say some of the surveillance video they have is from this business right here, but add they're not willing to share those images until they are certain it's the suspect's vehicle.
You don't want to get a false thing out there, people looking for the wrong thing.
Jason Holtzleiter, the deputy chief of police for the Greenwood Police Department, says they just want to get this case solved.
Come forward, clear it up. Let's get this solved and let's help the kid get better.
Webb's message to the person responsible is similar.
Turn yourself in. Just say, hey, I messed up. Face your consequences.
Working for you, Caitlin Kendall, WRTV.
Well, the boy told police he remembers crossing Main Street to get on the bus when he was hit. He added the next thing he remembered was waking up with people around him. If you have any information about this crash, you are asked to call the Greenwood Police Department at 317-882-9191. The number is on your screen. Or you can make an anonymous tip on the department's website.
Here's what you need to know when you are driving in the presence of a stopped school bus. On a standard two-lane road, vehicles traveling in both directions must stop for a school bus that has its stop arm extended. On a multi-lane road that doesn't have some kind of barrier, vehicles traveling in both directions must stop. On a divided highway, vehicles behind the bus must stop, but vehicles traveling in the opposite direction can proceed with caution.